Hello everyone, welcome to a new video. It's Bibi Cameron here and today I'm going to be sharing ideas and inspiration using the Tonic Craft Kit number 10. But first, let me show you the contents of the kit. You are going to get a spray bottle, this bottle with Nouveau Glitter Accents. You are going to get also shimmer powder, Nouveau Crystal Drops, a glue pen, two mini background stamps, Craft Perfect cardstock with different textures and colors, a folder to store your new Tonic Craft Kit dies and stamps, and of course a die set. This is a 10 pieces die set with these banners here. They have a stitched pattern all around the edge. You also get these frames, and one of these frames, the larger frame, also has an alphabet pattern. You will find also these alphabet dies. It has two different fonts, and one measure half inch and the other one measures 3/4 of an inch. You will also find these three tags in the set and an inner die to die cut at the center of that frame. So these are all the dies. Let me show you how these cut the paper and also emboss the paper. So there is three different designs and you can just write your name there, or if you have a stamp, you can stamp your name as well. Okay, so the first thing I wanted to do with some of the products in this kit is just a simple decorative banner and also a costume sentiment. So I have this stamp set here, it's called Sparkle and it's by Tonic Studios as well. And I'm using a piece of watercolor paper that measures 5 inches by 7 inches. And I'm going to be using the Tim Holtz stamping platform to stamp this image, also using Nouveau Hybrid Clear Ink. I'm going to stamp this twice just to make sure that the ink completely covers the surface of the paper, because the watercolor paper has a lot of texture. Then I'm going to move the paper a little bit and I'm going to place the stamp in this area here just to try to create a continuous pattern in that side of the panel. And I'm going to heat emboss this image using Gold Nouveau Fine Detail Embossing Powder. I really like these powders because they allow you to get a really nice and sharp embossed image. Now I'm going to use Nouveau Aquaflow pens and a cello bag, and I'm going to apply the ink of the pens over the cello bag like that, and I'm going to spray this with water. I'm going to try to cover the flowers with this red and yellow ink, and I'm going to add some splatters or smushing this against the watercolor paper to get a kind of texture in the background as well. Once this is done, I just like to heat set the ink so that I'm going to apply another layer of color, and I'm going to avoid blending those colors too much. So for example, here I'm going to use green colors and I'm going to apply this over the leaves, and the color is going to overlap any red area. It's not going to blend and get a brown color, which is not so nice when you are working with any water-based product. I also use a water brush to apply the ink directly on those areas in which I wanted a darker color or another specific color. So I just lift the ink from the glass mat and I just apply it directly on the watercolor paper. I also use this fuchsia glitter marker to add some accents here and there. You can use any color you like the most, and you can also use the glitter markers to apply the ink on a cello bag, spray this with water, and also apply it on the flowers. So I'm going to show you that here. So it's as simple as that, and you are going to get that intensity of that ink and that shimmer on the flowers as well. And I'm going to use now the banner dies. I'm going to use the smaller, this is the medium size die. So these dies here are going to allow me to create perfect banners with the plus of having that stitched pattern all around the edge. And I'm going to partially stamp this sentiment on that banner. And I'm going to show you how to do that. I'm going to use an anti-static powder there. And I'm going to apply ink, this is clear ink, only over the area of the image I want to stamp. And I'm going to heat emboss this image using white embossing powder. This one here is also ultra fine embossing powder. All I have to do here is to remove the excess of that anti-static powder and I'm ready to go. I'm going to stick the banner on the panel, but I thought that I could use the outer die or this die here to die cut a frame. I'm not going to use the alphabet frame because the pattern can easily get lost with all these images stamped on this panel. So I'm just going to keep it simple and I'm going to trim any excess of cardstock. And I'm going to use the glue pen to adhere the banner to the front of my card. I'm also going to use a double-sided foam in the back of this frame here. And I'm going to stick this down on a card base that measures 7 inches by 5 inches, just like this. And I'm going to glue this piece, also using the glue pen, just in the center of the frame. And then I trim any excess of cardstock. So this card measures 6 inches and a half by 5 inches. And now I'm going to use Craft Perfect Gold Mirror cardstock to die cut the alphabet. I'm also using underneath the paper a sticky fabric chim, and I explain how to make this fabric chim in the video for the craft kit number 9. But all I did was spray a fabric with a temporary and repositionable adhesive so that I place the paper on top of that fabric and I run that through the machine and all the die cuts are going to be temporarily adhered to that fabric so that I can find easily the letters and I'm not going to have all the die cuts flying around. Then when I have my word selected or the letters I need for my word, I'm going to use a piece of washi tape and just to keep the die cuts in place, and I'm going to apply the glue pen in the back of the die cuts. Then I'm going to place them on the banner and I'm going to press them down just like that. And I'm going to remove the washi tape, but I have to be very careful. I don't want to lift the letters, so I'm going to be very careful here. And I'm going to use a microfine black pen to add some dots and some accents to the flower. I was feeling at this point that the flowers were looking too red and the background was looking kind of all together and I want to add some contrast. So I'm not sure if I did something good or not, but that's what I did. So my idea with this card sample is to show you that you can use the supplies in the Tonic Craft Kits in many different ways. And today I use some of them to create a banner and this large frame around the card. And I also use the alphabet to personalize the message for this card. So now I'm going to show you some experiments we were doing with Emma before making that card. We were trying to die cut the letters from many different cardstocks to see how they look. And then you see there the mess. So I got the alphabet everywhere. So we decided that the best way to die cut this was using the fabric chim. And as always, it worked like a charm. After die cutting different cardstock colors, we got a lot of waste. And I decided to make something with that waste. So I also want to share with you these samples. I was here with my daughter, Emma. She's only 5 years old, but she loves crafting. And when I'm making a video, she has to be there. So what we did was making some easy backgrounds using Nuvo Aquaflow pens, applying the ink of the pens over the glass mat, spraying with water, and even Emma could achieve results at the first time she tried this. So once you have your backgrounds, you can use those panels you die code using the alphabet, and you can do something else. And just to give you extra ideas, I'm going to put together one tag. So I'm going to use a tag die by Tonic Studios to die code these pieces here. And I'm also going to use the banner because I want to create a little embellishment for the top of the tag. So you see how beautiful this banner just look itself for another project. But I'm going to use it here in this part of the tag. And I'm also going to use a punch to create a hole so that I can thread a ribbon, or I can pass a ribbon through that hole and I can just finish that part of the tag. Once I have this done, I'm going to use this butterfly die to die code a piece of paper. And I'm going also to use another banner. In this case, I'm going to place the banner like so on the die so that I get a double-ended banner. How do you say that in English? So I get that beautiful shape in both ends of the banner, as you can see there. I also decided to die code a butterfly from one of those watercolor backgrounds because I felt that the white butterfly wasn't popping up from that background. But once I placed the banner on top of the pink butterfly, the banner wasn't popping up. So I decided to stick the pink butterfly behind the white butterfly, and then I'm going to glue the banner on top. But first, I'm going to finish the banner, and I'm going to do exactly the same I did for the previous card in this video. I'm also using a washi tape to help me to keep the letters in place. And to stick the banner, I'm going to use a dimensional or a double-sided foam. So this is another tag I made also with that scrap piece of paper. And I made another two using the banners and the alphabet in different ways. Alright, I'm going to make a last card sample, and I'm going to be using this 1-inch circle punch to punch out one circle or two circles from each paper in the craft kit number 10, and I'm going to stick the letters just in the center of those circles as I'm showing there. I'm using this pickup tool, which is super handy because it helped me to move the paper with ease. And I'm also going to use a washi tape to keep all those circles together. So I took a little bit of time thinking how I was going to layer them up because they are a lot of circles. And this is a 6 by 6 inches card base. So when I managed to do it, I decided to stick in the back of each circle a double-sided a foam or a dimensional, and underneath that dimensional I also stuck a piece of metallic silver thread, as you can see there. I removed the washi tape, and then I need to guarantee that these strings are going to be straight. So this is the way I keep them straight and nice. Then I remove the backing of the foam adhesive from these other balloons, and I'm going to place this on that card panel like so. If when you are removing the washi tape, some of the letters stay on the washi tape, all you have to do is to remove it from the washi tape and stick it down again. And when I was gluing down these balloons on the front panel, I was being very careful and not getting trapped these strings in any other balloon foam adhesive. So I need to make sure that they keep straight and nice and tidy so that I can easily grab another string of or another piece of thread, and I can tie a knot like so. And then this super simple and clean composition is having a little bit more of sense. So all I have to do here is to trim the excess of thread, and I'm going to use a mini glue dot to stick this down and secure those strings in place. I'm also going to use this die here. It's a mini bow die to create a mini bow, and I'm going to stick that mini bow with a mini glue dot. So this is my card, and actually is such a fun card. I really like the look and feel of this card, and I think that if you add a nice colorful envelope, this is the kind of cards you can easily make and sell. So my aim today was making card samples in different styles, something very simple, something a little bit more artistic, or something more spontaneous, like these tags here made using the waste. But honestly, the sky is the limit, and I only use a couple of products in the kit. And that's all for today. I hope you enjoyed this video. Do not forget to subscribe to this channel. And if you wish to order this edition or further editions of the Craft Kit by Tonic Studios, you can click in the link in the video description to be redirected to the Tonic Craft Kit official website. You can also find the link to my blog post in the video description with pictures and supply list. Thank you very much for watching, and happy crafting. Bye.